Good morning and welcome to the Green Valley Parkinson's Support Group exercise class. Today we'll be doing some basic exercises that involve a light pair of hand weights, straight back chair, no arms, tennis ball, always have water, a larger ball, and today we'll be using a PVC pole pipe cut about 37 inches. And if you don't have that, maybe an umbrella that's not opened, a broomstick or something of that nature. So, or maybe just a long kitchen towel, something that's about like that. So we're gonna get started forward in the chair, placing your feet flat on the floor, not too wide and not too narrow, about hip width apart, and sitting tall. Take a deep breath through the nose. Hold it and let it out slowly through the mouth. Again. And out. Great job. Drop the chin to the chest, but sit tall in that chair, stretching the neck. And then lift the head and look up, relaxing the jaw, the mouth open slightly. Again, to the neutral position, side. Yeah. And to the other side. Center, and again, drop the chin to the chest and circle the head slowly. Those four positions. Let's reverse it. Good. You might hear some strange cracks. Drop the chin to the chest and again, look up. Mouth opens and center and turn and to the other side and turn again side to side. Perfect. And there for some shoulder rolls. Name that tune. Do you know that tune? Titanic. That's true. Yes. Yes. Up. And down, and up, and down. Two more. Up, and last one. Good. One forward, one back, with the focus always looking to the front. Good. And again. Yeah. And again. Perfect. There. Good. Back to a neutral position, the arms extended, fingers moving. Hi, Carla. Extend the fingers out, tapping finger to thumb. Good. And then spread the fingers out. Scratch. One, two, help me count. Three, four, one more.
Five.
Now make a fist for five. Two, three, good. Four, and squeeze and hold. Two, three, harder. Great job. Relax, spread them out, and roll the wrist. Yeah. Working on posture right now. Change the direction. Sitting tall. Good. And there. Small circles. For to warm up the shoulder, reverse it, larger circle. Sitting tall in the chair, change it again, one big circle. Good. And they end up overhead. Rotating the shoulder, do that big circle again, one more time around, and they end straight up. Reaching for the ceiling, it's one, and thank you, two, and three. And higher, four, last one, five, good. And they slowly come to the side with a flexed hand. Bring it to the shoulder and push out in for five, three, four, five. They come down, resting on the chair for a side stretch. Oh yeah, good. And to the other side, we'll be doing more of this with the pole. Good job. And then cross them. Sitting tall, twist the upper body. Perfect. And to the other side. And center. The hands on what's left of that chair, just there. And you're going to shift the weight, lifting the opposite hip up. And two. Good. And three. What did we nickname this?
Four.
Fire hydrant. For the obvious reasons. All right, holding on to that chair. We're going to sit tall, but lean back a little bit. And yes, you can use the back if you need to. We're going to lift these up. We're going to bicycle ride. So moving those knees, working the core. Woohoo. Are we there yet? Let's go backwards. Let's go forwards again. Great job. And down. Woo. Always have your water close at hand. We're going to grab the free weights now. And the grip that you use isn't real tight so that your fingers turn white. It's just a soft but a firm grip. There it goes again. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. We'll get it later. All right. Wrapping them and tucking the elbows. Starting with a bicep curl. Lift them up and to the shoulder and down. And they're parallel to the floor. Three. Four. I love it. Five. Good. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Great job. Take a quick break. Stretch maybe. Breathe a little deeper. Again, focus forward, lift it up and curl. One, two, three, four, five, good. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten, and down. Placing them on the floor underneath the chair and lacing the fingers together, sitting far away from the back, sitting tall, lift a knee, and these go just below the knee. Bring it up as high as you can. A circle. Might as well get a two for one here. Change the direction. For Elise. No? Moonlight Sonata? She knows. Yes, you're right. Reverse it. Good. And back into this position. One weight, both hands. Which one do I want? Well, they're both fives, so it doesn't matter. So we're going to wrap them and extend the arms. Shoulders relaxed, but the arms fairly straight as you drop the weight to the back, elbows high. Focus on something in front of you and extend and lower. Two. Good. Three. Four. You got it. Five. Six. Seven, eight, nine, ten, and down. Take a break. Breathe. Oh, I feel air conditioning. Feels good. All right. Again, they're wrapped and overhead, shoulders relax, the weight to the back, and it's up, down. Two, good. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and down, and placed again on the floor underneath your chair. We're going to scoot forward just a few inches, keeping the feet flat on the floor and that same width. Extend one. Fingers are here, sitting tall, reaching for the foot with a flat back, so you're reaching forward from the hip, and the focus is just beyond your foot. Press into the stretch. Good, and come all the way up. Nice. Again, reach and press and up. Bringing that leg in, extending the other one, hands by the knee, and reach, trying to keep the sole of your shoe on the floor, working on some flexibility in the ankle, and up. And again, reach for it. Oh, yes. And up. Good job. And back into this starting position where your feet, you know, if you were to lean side to side, you wouldn't feel too far off balance. Your arms are dropped on this one. Sit tall. Lift this knee. It's a flexed foot. Extend and point. Flex and point. Good. Three, four, it stopped. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, great job. Place it on the floor, shift a little weight, lift it up. It's a flex foot, point and flex. Two, three, use your outdoor voice. Five,
six,
seven, eight, good. Nine, 10, and again, right back to this position where we're gonna grab both weights. Why? Because we're gonna do some tricep kickbacks. Ah, fancy, fancy. Sit tall, wrap the fingers, drop the arms. And our chairs have little hooks on them, so don't get scratched. So sitting tall, we come forward just a little bit. Again, the focus is on the floor. Lift these up high, elbows to the back, pinch the shoulder blades, extend the arms behind you, fingers face the ceiling, curl it up, drop it down. That's one, this is two, and down, three, extend, bend, drop. Great job, four. Everyone loves these. Five, Kurt's thinking of something to say. Six, extend, bend, drop. Seven, to the back, good. And when they extend, squeeze, and down. Nine, and down. 10, to the back, bend, drop. And between sets, rest your fingers, take some deeper breaths. Yeah, no bathroom breaks, not that much time. All right, again, sit tall. Bring that weight forward, flat back. Lift them high, extend to the back. Bend and down. Two, good job. Down. Three, to the back. And drop. Four. And down. Five. Don't hold your breath. Six. Down, seven, squeeze it. Eight, oh yes, we're almost done. Nine, squeeze, bend, drop, last one. Whew, great job. All right, we're ready to, we're ready to put these down on the floor. Yes, and forward in that chair a little bit more. So you can lean back quite a bit and not touch the back of the chair. Extend that first leg out again. We've got a nice line to follow. The arms are here. Spread the fingers. Twist at the waist. Reach for the foot with the opposite hand. The other one reaches for the ceiling, looking down at your foot. Good job. And come up. Now try the other arm, reaching for the same foot. Reach and hold. Perfect. And there. Drop them, bring it in, the other here, opposite arm to leg, reach, nice job. Yes, and up, and again, reach. Oh yeah, and there, and we're gonna drop it back into a neutral position. If I were to turn the chair, which I'm not, I probably have this much space behind me, okay? So if you need to use the back for balance, go ahead, but in this class, it's best if you sit forward in the chair. And we're gonna grab one weight, just one, and we're gonna hold it with both hands. Extending the arms, don't lock the elbows, but that weight just rests between the knees. Sit tall in the chair. This is kind of a slow one and it stops right about there. Good, and down. Two, and down. Working the shoulders, three, four, five, can you feel this? Six, say yes and she'll stop. Seven, eight, nine, good, 10, and take a break. Yeah, you don't want to go too high. Shake it out a little. Posture is everything. So sit tall, again, wrap it, extend. They rest right there, right between your knees, sitting tall, not too high, and down. Good, two. It's the going down, it's the resistance that you want to work on. Four, it just floats down. Five, yeah, sure. Six, now are you feeling it? Seven, all right. Eight, nine, 10, and down. Super job. We're gonna place it on the floor. And this next exercise is for our hips. And I think he's called it picking up the baby. So we're gonna sit a little bit more forward in the chair and open those legs up wide. Within your range of motion, and that means flexibility as well. So you wanna kind of shift your weight. And they're twins down there. One at a time, we're going to pick it up. So sit tall. You're going to bend forward and get as close to the floor as you can, placing the hand underneath the baby. Lift the baby up towards you. Close, all the way, and all the way upright. Perfect. Good. Again, reach forward. There's twin babies down there, so we got to get the other one. Good. Pick it up. Super. And up. Great job. All right. Walk these back in. Heel, toe, heel, toe, into a closed position where the feet touch and the knees touch. The arms are crossed. Again, we transfer that weight forward, looking down at the floor with a flat back. You're going to press on the outside of the foot and the knees open. Good job. And together and up. Again, transfer the weight and there. And sitting tall, uncross, and bring the feet back to the starting position. They're out, and the shoulders are down, and the hands are relaxed. Flex. Two, pull them back. Three, four, one more, five. You end up like this, and then we're gonna make a fist and drop and stretch. Two, three, four, five. This always feels good to me. Extend the fingers and cross the arms, rotating them inward, they connect. And arms overhead, pull them back as far as you can, but don't drop the chin to the chest. Good. And down. And all the way back. Good. And down. And one more. Halfway down, stop. Place the other arm on top, lock the fingers, and stretch. Usually, someone's less flexible on one side. It's always my left. All right, there you go. Good. And all the way down, separating the hands, extending one, crossing the straight arm across the chest, this hand underneath, pressing. Good. And then here, press. Good job. They're out. Fingers spread apart. Close them, open, close and open. Three, four, five. And then curl them up. Spock hand. All right. And a really tight fist. Drop the wrist and lift it up. Slowly open. Yeah. And then form circles. Finger to thumb. Pressing. Name that tune, Nancy. Got her this time. Finger flicks. I don't either. So there. Again, how is your posture? Extend that, palms up. Grab the fingers with the other hand. Pull them down. I could have said anything. She might have believed it. Fingers up, pull them back. And then the other here. Pull them down. Oh. Yeah. And pull them back. Good job. All right. Sitting tall in the chair, trying to get rid of as many wrinkles in your shirt, so lengthen the spine. We're going to do a chair lift. It requires nothing more than the chair. So your hands are here, a little forward with the weight. Lift yourself off the seat and down. Good. Up and down for 10. Three, four, good. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and down. In a closed position, feet touch and knees touch, and we're going to be out just a little bit more. Hold on, lean back just a little, and the knees come to the chest and down. It's up, two, three, four, good, five, six, keep going, seven, eight, you've got it, 9, 10, and down, and then separate the feet, extend the arms for some toe touches. It's up and up and two. This is the warm-up for cardio. Three, four, five, yeah, six, seven, eight, nine, good, 10, and down, and back into the starting position with weights in hand. We're going to place them on our legs, out to the edge with an open hand on top, looking forward. Extend a straight leg out. Focus is out in front. It's a straight leg lift for 10. It's up, 2, sitting tall, 3, good job, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bring it back and extend the other. Sit tall and lift and lower. 2, good, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and down. And you want to make that a little more challenging? Heavier weights. All right, we're going to place those on the floor for now. And grab the tennis ball or ball of socks or an orange. We're going to use a tennis ball to warm up our hands. And think of Fabergé egg. I wish. It's better than the soft egg that he was using. All right, roll it. Roll it, roll it, roll it. Wake up your hands. Think of your posture as you sit here. And then stretch the fingers. Work it in between. Think of your posture. Sit tall in the chair, close your eyes, and extend one arm. Make a soft fist. Place that ball on top. See if you can just hold it there, extending the arm away from that body. With your eyes closed, extend the other arm and transfer the ball to that hand. And hold it there. Good job. Open your eyes. You did it. Yes. And I never know if they're doing it or not with my eyes closed. The ball on the floor, the foot on the ball, push down. And people in class are lucky enough to have the time to take their shoes off, either that or they had sandals on today. They get a better feel for that. So push down as you roll back and forth. Everyone should have a tennis ball at home for these. And the other foot, push down, roll. Wake up your feet. All right. Grab the ball and squeeze it back into the chair. At this time, that umbrella or dish towel or PVC pole, that's what we're going to grab. And we're going to do some more stretches. So holding that with your hands at the edge and the arms extended, you're going to let it rest just between the thumb and the index finger. So you're really not going to hold on to it because that's cheating. So it's here. You'll see why. This is going to be a lateral stretch. So as far back without causing any pain in the shoulder that you can do, you're going to stretch to the side, looking forward. Now, don't pull that up, but use the oblique muscles. Use your waistline. Good job. And up. Because if you were holding on to it, then you'd pull up, and that's cheating. So we want to use the oblique muscles. Good. Two more on each side. Stretch it. I love using this little fixture because it really works well. Good job. Last one. And center. Now hold on to it and drop it about chest height. You want to focus in the middle of that pipe as you twist the upper body. Now back arm, pull the front arm, keep going, go twist that spine and hold. Good. And then find center to the other side. The back arm now pulls, keep going. Perfect. And there. And then we're going to hold on to it. Hands kind of close together, and transfer it from one hand to the other. Don't place it, but it just kind of pops over there. It just knows when to hold on and when not to. Close your eyes. See if you can keep doing that. Maybe separating those hands a little bit more.
Getting ready for a trapeze.
Is that what you think of? That's true. All right, good job. I didn't hear any poles drop. So we're going to hold it about shoulder width apart. And this is for your wrist. So look at it as you roll. I like this one. Good. You got it. And because we put our shoes on, we're not going to take them off again. But another good thing to do is to put this on the floor and, like we did with the ball, roll back and forth. And help to wake up all the nerve endings on the bottom of your feet. That's where our balance begins. The last one is I'm going to have you turn at an angle in the chair. And you want to sit tall in the chair, stacking the hands. The pole out quite a ways so that you're reaching. The worst thing that could happen is that you don't extend and your hands, they slip, and that happens. So you want to get this far away and reaching from the hip, you want to walk your hands down, 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 down. Good. Now you see why we did the baby, pick up the baby, because that was a warm up. As close to the floor as you can, and then stack them again. Walk all the way up. Good. One more time. Reach forward, and then walk it, walk it, walk it, walk it. Good. Bending at that waist. Hold, and come all the way up. Great job. There. We're done with that. Dun, dun, dun. Or we could sword fight. No, just kidding. Now take this, place it the back of the chair legs. And we're going to do some sit to stands. A little different class today, but can't always do the same thing. We get bored. All right. So we're going to transfer that weight forward, nose over toes, feet apart. Come on up. Great job. As you bend to go back down, the weight is in the heel. You know the chair is there. Super job. Again, here. Bend. Transfer the weight. Good. And back. And the last one, all the way up. We're going to be behind the chair. I'm going to take this and put it far away. Standing to the back of that chair, arms distance from it, make sure your feet are in that same position that they were seated, about hip width apart, for some heel lifts. It's up, it's down. Two, good, focus forward. Three, smiles are optional.
Four.
Yes. Five, good. Six, work it. Seven, we're going to hold on. Ten, eight, just thought I'd tell you. Nine, focus forward and go up and hold. Two, three, four, five, drop the heels. Place the hands on the back of the chair. The weight is in the heel as you lift the toes up for ten. Two, good. Three, pull them back. Four, five, six, yes. Seven, eight, nine, 10 and down. And I'm going to turn just a little bit so the camera can still see. We're still in this position. The weight, though, more on the ball of the foot. Fingers on the chair. You're going to come forward, bend from the hip, and take a bow. It's a flat back. Your focus on the seat of your chair. Right in that position. Good. And then come up slowly to a standing position, shift the weight to one leg, the focus forward as this extends to the back. Straight leg lifts for 10. It's up, two,
three.
All right, four, five, good, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Bend the front knee, the heel pressing to the floor. Great job. And come up, bring it forward, shift the weight, the focus is forward as you extend, two, three, four, good, five, six, seven, eight, Kurt, be careful, nine, 10, bend. You okay?
Yeah, I pulled my back yesterday.
Now that's on you, not me. All right, bring it in. Please don't overdo.
I'm not.
Overachiever. All right. Okay, kicks to the back, kick it and stretch it. Two, three, should you be doing that? Okay. Five. 6, good, 7, kick, 8, stretching the quads, 9, 10, good. To the side of the chair for marches, because we're going to do a new balance exercise. So about hip width apart, the weight though on the inside leg, the hand on the chair, it's up, up, 2, and 3, yeah, move those arms if you want, 5, and 6, good, and 7, 8, 9, 10, great job. Today, we're going to be doing an exercise called Rock the Boat, and it's a standing balance exercise. Why don't we practice it behind the chair, because that way you can use the back of the chair if need. Your feet about hip width apart, and maybe I'll demonstrate it so that you can actually see. If I were standing, the chair were in front of me, the weight, get a feel for this. It's just going to shift from side to side. The focus forward, the arms dropped, relax the shoulders. Yeah. Now, whatever side you decide to be the standing leg, shift all of this over, focus, and lift this up. Beautiful. Place it on the floor, right back where it was. Shift all of this over that. Focus forward and lift it up. Eyes off the floor. Good job. And the instructions say, you'll get a kick out of this, no more than 30 seconds.
Okay.
Okay? So shift. I'm like, are you kidding me? Yeah. And you really get a feel of what happens when you lean too far and you counterbalance just to get that leg higher. You want to make sure this is over that leg. So shift it, focus. The arms, drop them down. If you need a finger or two on the back of the chair, use it. But they're here to help you balance. And this, that weighs about 8 pounds right over your shoulders. Good. Again, shift and look. Great job. And back. Good. Now do it kind of fast. It's no big deal, is it? Right? Just like our marching. We're going to do the same thing with a forward and back. And this time we'll be standing to the side of the chair. Feet apart, the weight on the inside leg, the weight here, step forward. It's a split step. Use the chair if you need to, forward and back. Yeah, that toe comes up, this heel comes up, back and forth, good. Use the chair, because you're gonna lean back and lift the outside back leg up. This is something that we've done before. Focus forward, shift the weight, inside back leg lifts. Yeah, it's all about placement. You feel that, don't you? Yeah, knowing just where it should be. This is the center of your balance. Great job. Try the other side. We're to the side of the chair. Take a step forward with the outside foot. Stagger those feet. Make sure that you start in the center. Get a feel for that. Back and forth. Good. Focus out in front. Let's go back first. Use the chair. If you need it, lift it up. Maybe 3 or 4 inches, not too high. Place it, shift the weight forward, good job. Inside leg up. Back again, front leg forward. And forward, back leg up. Good. Now do a little faster, like a little rocking horse. Yeah, great job, all right. The poles, be careful of them if you still have them by your chairs. We're gonna do some cardio, all right? So. Keep in motion. Y'all, some of you know that I'm from Santa Barbara, so yes, I chose the Beach Boys. Back in the day when you could actually go to concerts, do you remember that? Yeah.
find my 409. She's real fine, my 409, my 409. Well, I saved my pennies and I saved my dimes.
Good job. Job. Yes. Did you really? Do you wish you still had it? Yeah, no kidding. Yes, it would. I hear you breathing, and that's a good thing. I'm breathing just like that. Good. All right, a little out of breath, I hope. Back into the chair, like we practice, with a weight. Where'd they go? Forward in the chair. This is the last one. So wrap the fingers straight up, forward with a flat back. Reach for it, drop, and up. Let's hear it. Two. And up. Three. Flat back. Lift it up. Six and down and up. Five. Good. And up.
Six.
Is that six? I've lost it. Seven. Thank you, Kurt, for helping. Eight. I'm going with her. Two more if you're following this. Nine. And if not, you're with me. Ten. Down, out, and up. Easily distracted. The fan turns on and I'm like, huh? Okay. So place that on the floor. Great job today. We've got cool down. Back to where we started. Sit tall. Take a deep breath through the nose. Out slowly through the mouth. Again. Exhale. One more. And let it out. Drop the chin to the chest and lift the head to a neutral position to the side and up. To the other side and down, dropping the chin to the chest. Slowly circle the head. Reverse the circle. Good job. Drop it forward and lift it up forward last time. And center the shoulders to the front and up by your ears. Pull them back and down. Circle. And the other way. Yeah. All right, there. Not quite done there. Place them, elbows out, they touch and they stretch. Touch and stretch. One more. Touch, stretch, bring it back and unfold them. Soft hands, turning a doorknob, rotating arm and shoulder. And then give yourself a big squeeze, tuck the chin. Open the arms. Another one. And stretch. A, E, I, O, U. One more time. A, E, I, O, U. Thank you very much for joining us today. Come back and see us on Friday. Have a great day. Thank you.